हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द चैप्टर नंबर 11 दैट इज़ द वर्क एंड एनर्जी. सो स्टूडेंट अंडर दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन डिटेल अबाउट द वर्क डन, द वेरियस टाइप ऑफ द वर्क डन लाइक द नेगेटिव, पॉजिटिव एंड द जीरो वर्क डन, एनर्जी, वेरियस फॉर्म्स ऑफ द एनर्जी, ऑफकोर्स देयर फॉर्मूलाज, then the about the power, what is the unit of the power, etc. So these are the topics which we are going to discuss under this video. So students, as we all know from the previous chapters also, we have studied that all living beings need the food. Living beings have to perform the several basic activities to survive. We call such activities as the life processes. So students, the energy for these processes comes from the food. We need energy for the other activities also. The other activities like the playing, singing, reading, writing, thinking, jumping, cycling and running. So for doing all these activities, we need the food, and with the help of the food, we get the energy. Likewise, animals too also get engaged in the activities. For example, they may jump and run. They have to fight, move away from the enemies, find food or find a safe place to live. Also, we engage some animals to lift the weights, carry loads, pull carts or the plow fields. All such activities requires the energy. So student, in the scientific manner, whatever the example I have given you so far, no work is done in the above cases. For example, another example I will give you. Suppose a man is completely exhausted in trying to push a rock or wall, but the work done is zero. Why so? Because the wall or the rock is stationary. Same way, a man standing still with the heavy suitcase may be tired soon, but he does no work in this situation also. Why so? Because he is stationary. Nothing has been moved. So no work has been done here also. So students, let us decide that what is work? Actually, what is the work? So student, there is a difference in the way we use the term work in day-to-day life and the way we use it in a science. So students, what is basically a work? Work is said to be done if on applying a force on an object, it is displaced from its position in the direction of the force. Students, from the point of the scientific, following are the two conditions which is needed to be satisfied for the work to be done. One is, a force should act on an object, a force must applied on an object, and the object must be displaced. If any one of these conditions does not exist, then the work is not done. Here in this example, you can see a man trying to pull a wooden box, and the wooden box moves through a distance also. So what happened in this way? He has exerted a force on the wooden box and it is displaced. Hence the work is done. So basically, what is the work? Work is said to be done if on applying a force, likewise in the picture, a man is pushing a wooden box, he is applying a force on the wooden box, and it is displaced from its position in the direction of the force, and the wooden box is displaced from its position, from the rest position it has been displaced, where the in the direction of the force applied. So by the how we can say that the work is said to be done? There are certain changes in an object which tells us that the object or the work is said to be done. First is, a moving object comes to the rest when you catch a ball. So a force is required to stop the moving ball. So the moving ball comes to the rest. So a moving object comes to the rest. That means the work is said to be done. When an object at the rest starts moving, when you kick a ball, when you place a ball in the ground, and when you start to kick it, it starts moving. So initially the object was at the rest and then it started moving. Velocity, or we can say the speed of an object, changes. Initially, suppose the object is moving very slowly, After applying the force, it starts, it speeds up. So that means the work is said to be done, or the shape of an object changes. So these are the four things which will prove, or we can say it is the proof which tells us that the work is said to be done. Now students, we have already know the concept of the work. Now let us discuss the work done by a constant force. So student, first question is, how is work defined in the science? To understand this, we shall first consider the case when the force is acting in the direction of the displacement. As you can see in the picture, suppose let a constant force F is acting on an wooden blocks, as you can see in the picture by a man, and that wooden blocks be displaced through a distance d in the direction of the force as described in the figure. Let W be the work done. Now students, we define the work done, which is to be equal to the product of the force and the displacement. That means the work done is equal to the force into the displacement. So student, the work done by a force acting on an object is equal to the magnitude of the force multiplied by the distance moved in the direction of the force. Work has only the magnitude and no direction. That is why the work is known as the scalar quantity, because it doesn't have the direction but only the magnitude we know. Now students, suppose here if the force applied by the man is the one unit, and the distance traveled by that wooden block in the direction of the force is d, which should be, so let's suppose d is equal to 1 meter. So then the work done by the force will be 1 newton meter. Here the unit of the work is the newton meter, or we can say the joule. So student, 1 joule is the amount of the work done when the force of 1 newton moves a body through a distance of 1 meter in its own direction. Then the work done is said to be the 1 joule. Here 1 joule is equal to the 1 newton into the 1 meter. So 1 joule is equal to the 1 newton meter. Now students, to understand the work done, let us solve one example. Suppose a force of 5 newton is acting on an object. As you can see, A is the initial position of the body. Okay, so now the displacement is say about the 2 meter. So first, when we applied the force of the 5 newton at the position A on the body displaces and it moves to the 2 meter and finally reaches to the point B in the direction of the force. So if the force acts on the object through the displacement, what is the work done in this case? Now can anyone tell me what is the work done? So in the previous slide we have discussed that the work done is equal to the force into displacement. So students, here the force is given the 5 newton, and the displacement d, or we can say the s, is given as the 2 meter. So work done is equal to the 5 into 2. So work done is equal to the 10 newton meter, or we can say work done is equal to the 10 joules. Now students, there are the following two factors on which the amount of the work done depends. That is, the first one is the magnitude of the force. That is, the magnitude of the force means the amount of the force applied on a body. So whatever the amount of the force, that is, if the force is greater will be the amount of the work done. Okay, same way if we say vice versa, the greater the work done, the greater the force. Second factor is the displacement. Greater the displacement, greater is the amount of the work done, and vice versa. That means if the amount of the work done is much, then the displacement will be greater. So students, work done by a force, it can be positive, negative or zero. So students, moving on, when the force, suppose the F force, and the displacement, suppose S, are in the same direction, that is the angle between the direction of the force and the displacement is zero, then the work done will be positive. That is, work is done by the force. For example, you can see here a girl is trying to pull the trolley car towards herself. So that means the force is applied in the direction of the motion. So the work done will be here will be positive. Okay, so this is the positive work done. Now students, moving on, when the force F and the displacement S are in the opposite direction, that is the angle between the direction of the force and the displacement is 180 degree. So here the work done will be the negative, that is the work is done against the force. For example, frictional force acts in the direction opposite to the direction of the displacement. So work done here by the friction force will be negative. So student, for this, let us take one example. The football, when you are playing the football, after kicking the football slows down due to the force of the friction acting in a opposite direction of the motion of the football. Thus here the work done is negative. So the negative sign indicates that the work done is against the gravity. So student, we conclude that if the work done against the direction of the motion, that is the gravity, then it is taken as the negative. Now student, the last but not the least, the zero work done. So here students, when the force and the displacement are in the perpendicular direction, that is the angle between the direction of the force and the displacement is 90 degree, so the work done is zero here. For example, you can see in the picture that the moon moves around the earth in the circular path. So the force of the gravitation acts on the moon at the right angles to the direction of the motion of the moon, as you can see in the picture. So here the work done is the zero. Another example we can take, suppose a coolie, you in the railway station you have must seen the coolie. A coolie carrying the load on his head. In this case the gravitational force is acting vertically downward, that is the weight of the load. And the displacement is along the horizontal direction, that is the force and the displacement are perpendicular to each other. So in this case the work done by the gravitational force is the zero. Now students, let us see some one example of the work done. Now here is one numerical, that is a coolie lifts a luggage of the 15 kg from the ground and put it on his head 1.5 meter above the ground. Calculate the work done by him on the luggage. So students, here the mass of the luggage is the 15 kg and the displacement is 1.5 meter. So the work done will be, we have known that the work done is always equal to the force into the displacement. But student, here the mass is given, force is not given. So here the formula for finding out of the force is the mass into the force of the gravity. So here the gravity, the g, we have taken 10 meter per second square, that is the force of gravity, that is it is constant. So student, if in the numerical the force is not given, by this you can find out the force, mass into 10 meter per second square, g, that is the force of the gravity. Here the g we will take as the force of the gravity. So it is constant and everywhere you have to use this constant only. So instead of the force, I can write the mass into 10, that is the force of gravity, into the displacement, that is 1.5 meter. So the final answer will be 225 kilogram mass per second square. So the formula, the answer will be 225 joules or 225 newton meter, because the unit of the force we have discussed is the newton meter. So since here the work done will be the 225 25 joules.